وتمنعني. It waves and then shows enmity and fight those who want to show harshness and enmity to them, and it prevents them from coming into their land. So this is part of the history of the Arab in Medina. These are the Arabs who were living in Medina, which used to be called Yathrib as the old name of Medina. Inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we continue, and please write down your notes and write down your doubts and questions so we can follow up inshallah and cope and manage between the paragraphs and statements. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. وصلى الله وسلم على رسولنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.
This audio file has been recorded and distributed by SalafiTapes.com.
الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبيه ومصطفى نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اشتن بسنته واهتدى بهداه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، حياكم الله وبياكم. We are with the subject of who is Rasulullah, and we are going to introduce Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم as we said yesterday from a book that speaks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But before that, we said that we're going to speak about, as the book goes, about the general situation in the Arabian Peninsula before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the prophethood, and before he was given the message to convey and deliver. As we said yesterday, that it says here, فلما خرج مفطيا من اليمن وملك غسان بالشام. When مفطيا is one of the kings of Yemen, he left Yemen and he became a king, the king of the tribe called Ghassan or Ghassakina in Ash-Sham. Ash-Sham is the land where Lebanon, mainly Syria, Jordan, Palestine is today. Then Mithya, the king of Ash-Sham, died, and his son Ta'ala became the king after him. He was called Ta'labatul Anqa. Then Ta'labatul Anqa again died, him also, and after him his son, his brother Ta'labatul Amr ibn his nephew, Ta'labatul Amr, the son of the brother of Ta'labatul Anqa. Ta'labatul Anqa and Ta'labatul Amr are brothers. Sorry, Ta'labatul Anqa and Jibna are brothers. Jibna has a son called Ta'labatul Amr. He became the king after his uncle died. However, his son disagreed with his father on certain issues, as Ibn Khaldun says in his book. So he traveled to Yathrib, where the Aus and Khazraj tribes are living at that time. And he became a friend of the Jew of Khaybar. And he asked him for, he called him for an agreement, an obligation, that everyone is, that everyone provides good neighborhood and security to the other. So they accepted what he suggested. Ibn Sa'id, one of the scholars of the Seerah, said that at that time the king of Yemen was Sharib ibn Ka'b, Sharib the son of Ka'b. And they were in the desert, somewhere in the desert. And they remained there living simple life up until the whole situation changed upside down. And leadership became a matter of who has more people and stronger fighters. In that time, the Yahud, the Jew, used to be living there. He used to be living around in the Arabian Peninsula, because they have in their book that the prophet of the end of this time of this world, the seed prophet, is going to be sent from a place in between two lavas. In between two places called the two lavas, and the cities in between, that is Medina. For those who visited Medina, or those who are going to visit Medina soon, inshallah, the ones who visited it already saw, maybe, but the ones who are coming to visit Medina recently, they gotta see this on the way from Jeddah to Medina, especially if they come to Jeddah airport and then they take coach to Medina. They gotta see just a few kilometers before Medina these lava exploded around there. And so the Yahud do scattered in that area, willing, every tribe of them willing to have the life and seed forward from amongst them. Haris ibn Ta'alab, as you remember, we just mentioned that, is the one the son of Ta'alab ibn Ta'alab Amr, who left his father traveling to Yathrib at that time. Haris ibn Ta'alab, Haris son of Ta'alab, at that time he used to have two sons. One of them is called Aus, and the other is called Khazraj. So, Haritha, as we said, had two sons. One is called Aus and the other is called Khazraj. Their mother is called Qayla. Qayla, the daughter of Al-Arqam, the son of Amr, the son of Jibna. And so they stayed in Yathrib for a while until they became big and strong families and tribes. So they were all, the Aus used to be lived by Malik ibn Aus. And from them is a man called Khatmat ibn Jashm ibn Malik. Khatmat is the son of Jashm, the son of Malik. And Ta'alaba, as well as Lawban and Awf. All these are the children of Amr ibn Awf ibn Malik. And from the children of Awf ibn Amr, is a man called Hanash, another called Malik. What? Kalfa. All these are children of Ayr. Anyway, Khazraj, the other tribe of Al-Ansar, are five main families. One belongs to Ka'b. And others belong to Amr. Others belong to Awf. Others to Jashm. Others to Al-Harith. So from Ka'b ibn al-Khazraj, from Ka'b the son of al-Khazraj, came children of Ida ibn Ka'b, Sa'ida. And the lineage to Sa'ida is al-Sa'idi. And from Amr ibn Khazraj came Banu Najjar, and they are Taymullah ibn Ta'alaba ibn Amr. So